Good evening, and welcome to our second Dean's Lecture for 2021. I'm Janet Clinton, the Deputy Dean of the Melbourne Graduate School of Education, and I'm standing in for our Dean, Professor Jim Watterson, who is completing quarantine after a small trip to Sydney. I would like to start by acknowledging the traditional custodians of the lands on which our graduate school stands. We pay our respects to the elders, past, present, and emerging, for they hold Indigenous Australia's memories, traditions, cultures, and hopes. We must never forget that under the concrete and the asphalt, the land, sea, and waterways were and will always be traditional Indigenous land. Today's lecture is a part of our acknowledgement of NAIDOC Week, which celebrates the history, culture, and achievements of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander peoples. This year's theme, Hill Country, means embracing First Nations cultural knowledge, understanding of country, and a part of Australia's national heritage. Healing Country also means finally resolving many of the outstanding injustices which affect the lives of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander peoples, and working towards redressing historical injustice. Our speaker today has worked tirelessly to raise these issues throughout her long, varied and distinguished career, and we're privileged to hear from her. Dr. Lois Peeler is of the Yorta Yorta and Wiradjuri history from her mother and Wurundjeri heritage from her father. She is currently the Executive Director and Principal of Worawa Aboriginal College. Lois's upbringing included family life on the Kamaragunja Aboriginal Reserve and the river flats of the Murupuna, where activism for improved conditions for Aboriginal people was deeply embedded. She grew up surrounded by strong women and men who, based on their lived experience, led the fight for equal rights for Aboriginal people to education, healthcare, housing, legal services, and social justice. Lois has had a diverse career in the music industry, public service, community development, social activism, tourism, and Aboriginal education. One of the members of the Sapphires, an all-girls singing group from the 1960s, she was also acknowledged as Australia's first Aboriginal model and TV presenter. A dynamic contributor to Aboriginal affairs, Lois has held many positions in government, community, the corporate and philanthropic sectors. She's had senior positions in the state and federal public service. And she became the director of the Aboriginal Employment Unit within the Office of Merit Protection of the Victorian Public Service. Among her many achievements, Lois was the founding member of the National Federation of Aboriginal Women and was also a founding member of the Koori Women's Mean Business and appointed to the Victorian Women's Advisory Committee. In 2014, she was made a member in the General Division of the Order of Australia for her significant service to Indigenous community as well as an educator, advocate and role model. In 2020, she was inducted into the Victorian Women's Honour Roll. Lois is currently the Chair of the Department of Justice Eastern Metropolitan Regional Aboriginal Justice Advisory Committee, a member of the Aboriginal Justice Caucus and statewide Aboriginal Justice Forum, as well as the Chair of the Aboriginal Independent Prison Visitors Program. As you can see, she has made a significant contribution to Indigenous communities as an educator, activist, and she serves as a role model to us all. It is therefore my great pleasure to welcome Dr. Peeler to deliver her Dean's Lecture on Learning from the Land, a case study of Worawa Aboriginal College.
There are mornings in the Yarra Valley and ranges when the sun is slow to rise. It's cold. In gullies, tussock and grass are damp underfoot, and black soil is damp under the tussock. The land is edged with timber, manigam, messmate, and mountain ash. And under this shelter acacia and ferns and an abundance of birds. Bellbirds, the currawong, and kookaburra. On these mornings, a wet fog smokes and wraps itself around the forest. Trunk and branch and leaf are coiled and made hidden. And from the forest, the fog stretches itself out over the risings and fallings of land. On these mornings, we at first see only apparitions and vague shapes. On these mornings, at first nothing is certain. What we know is what we remember. What existed before, what has been passed to us. But then comes magic. The sun works harder and harder still, and the fog writhes away and made to glow by a golden light, the quality of crystal, clear and sharp. The air is made pure. Breathing becomes easy. And the land. The valley floor, the steep slopes, the green of eucalyptus, the ridges far distant, is revealed as an inspiration, a celebration, a sacrament, and a compact that exists between the past and the future. I would like to begin by acknowledging the land wherever you are situated today. I pay my respects to the traditional custodians and elders past and present. Today, I am on the traditional lands of the Woiwurrung Wurundjeri. I honour our spirit ancestors, Bunjil the Eagle Hawk and Wah the Crow, the moieties that connect me to this place and to those who walk the land. Aboriginal Australians are linked to their traditional country through their language group and through creation stories from the dreaming. These stories are often about how features of the landscape were formed, and they also affirm important cultural, community values and customary laws. Looking after the land, its environmental, cultural and spiritual well-being is the responsibility of traditional custodians of that land. Our intimate connection to land has been forged over the eons. It is the basis of our belief system, our moiety system, our totem, our law, our kinship system, our cultural ceremony, our spiritual nourishment, and the resting place of our ancestors. Nurturing the land was and is a large part of our responsibility. While we were nurtured by the land, it is Aboriginal belief that we, being a part of the land itself, must give back. We did this through ceremony and in the way we moved around the land, gathering seasonal yield and then leaving to regenerate. The land is our greatest legacy, and the essence of our understanding of being, our spirituality. Everything about Aboriginal society is inextricably woven with and into and connected to the land. Culture is the land and spirituality of Aboriginal people. Our culture beliefs or reason for existence is the land. So when we talk, dance, sing and paint the land, we are celebrating the land. Today, I would like to talk about Worawa Aboriginal College as a case study of learning from the land. Worawa Aboriginal College is an Aboriginal initiative, Aboriginal owned and operated and developed from the lived experiences of Aboriginal people themselves. Established in 1983, it is an Aboriginal organisation governed by a majority Aboriginal board and registered as a specialist school by the Victorian Registration and Qualifications Authority, the VRQA. The specialist nature of Worawa's operations lie in its integrated model, which combines personal development, intensive health and well-being programs with strong formal education principles and underpinned by Aboriginal ways of knowing, doing and being. With cultural activities led by Aboriginal elders, focusing on Aboriginal values and pride in Aboriginal heritage. Located on a landscape of Aboriginal cultural and spiritual significance, the Worawa Property Management Plan emphasises respect for the environment and renewal of the land in keeping with centuries-long Aboriginal traditions in caring for country. And this is for the benefit of current inhabitants and for future generations. The education program at Worawa has been designed to educate the whole person across all domains of their development, social, emotional, physical, spiritual, cultural, and academic. A boarding school for young Aboriginal women in the secondary years of schooling, the college delivers a holistic education through an integrated education, culture, and well-being model of education. The college program is imbued with the essence of Aboriginal spirituality, and the college pedagogy is steeped in learning from the land. These reflect the communal and relational nature of Aboriginal knowledges that connect individuals with family and kin and country, culture, and spirituality. At Worawa, our cultural practice includes relationship to the country, environment, recognizing the creator spirits and country, welcome to country and smoking ceremonies and cleansing ceremonies, healing and other spiritual practice. Cultural continuity, honoring the land through dance and song, traditional and contemporary. Talking story, narrative, yarning, acting. For example, Strong Girl, Sapphire's production, You Can't Do That fashion presentation at Melbourne Museum, and the Council of Elders who share stories and cultural practice. Our Aboriginal culture is an oral and visual tradition. Throughout centuries, what is widely known as the arts has been a method of communication in Aboriginal culture, used for ceremonial purpose, for the sharing of instructive information, as a means of honouring the land and waters for the seasonal shield and affirmation and celebration of cultural identity. So in the Aboriginal worldview, the arts incorporate our rich heritage expressed through narrative, song, dance and visual artistic expression from both traditional and contemporary perspectives. At Worawa, using the ancient traditions of narrative and the arts, students are encouraged to relate the methods of the ancestors in the transmission of culture through the oral tradition, yarning, song, and dance, thus empowering them through honouring their stories whilst engaging with the arts. Arts are entirely integrated into our program, and beyond the skills learnt and pieces created, arts provide a time where spirits are calm and students work together harmoniously to create wonderful works to share with others. It is exciting to see the girls sharing dances from different areas as diverse as the Kimberley, Elko Island and Central Desert, taking on the responsibilities of being custodians and teachers, honouring and sharing their stories and knowledge with confidence and pride. This has facilitated those with deep connection to culture to share dance and their meaning with those who long to learn. We have had a feast of wonderful dance lessons, ranging from traditional styles and concepts, from classical to hip hop. Our students enjoy and excel at dance, traditional dances perform on significant occasions. As well as traditional and contemporary arts practices, personal and community narratives, the arts also include new perspectives and expression of identity, stories, history, and experiences of contemporary Aboriginal Australia, which may combine traditional, contemporary, and emerging media and materials. Audio and/or visual aspects involve other learning areas and exist in physical, digital, or virtual spaces to be created individually or collaboratively. The Worawa Cadet Ranger Program provides another means of learning from the land. The design of the Worawa Cadet Ranger Program combines both traditional Aboriginal perspectives and modern scientific practice. You heard earlier about the cultural significance of the land on which Worawa Aboriginal College is situated. It sits in an ancient landscape of great natural beauty, nestled at the foot of a spectacular mountain landscape that forms part of the Great Dividing Range, which is Australia's largest mountain range. And it runs along the whole east coast of Australia. Along the length of that Great Dividing Range, archaeological evidence points to Aboriginal occupation. Rock art and burials, and the bogong moth traditionally was a major source of food for Aboriginal tribes in southeastern Australia. And during the season, it was a cause for tribal gatherings and for harvesting and feasting on the delicacy of the bogong moth. This gathering of the tribes was important for ceremony, for trade, and marriage arrangements. So focus areas of knowledge of the Worawa Cadet Ranger Program include the landscape features and formation processes, geographical features of the landscape and climate, interpretation skills with reference to traditional protocols and customs, and use of modern scientific equipment such as drones in land management. Processes related to the research of native animals using infrared cameras, caring for country, sustainability and environment. A recent addition to the program is the propagation of native plants in our climate control greenhouse for food and the extraction of oil from particular plant species as part of our STEM project. Within this learning structure, Worawa Cadet Rangers undertake training in school, in environmental settings, and within work placements made possible through partnerships with a number of organisations, including the CSIRO, Swinburne University, Hillsville Sanctuary, the University of Melbourne, and the Bureau of Meteorology, who have previously worked with students in areas of science and technology in relation to Indigenous seasonal calendars based on observing the weather conditions and changes in nature. I am particularly pleased that Worawa has a long-standing partnership with the University of Melbourne which has provided learning experiences for our students in a range of areas, including orientation visits to the university and introduction to gene technology. The University of Melbourne School of Computing and Information Systems has, for a number of years, worked with students in a number of projects, which has included the development of a prototype for storytelling on our history walk, and use of drones and computer programs to maneuver the drones. So over the nearly 40 years of existence, Worawa Aboriginal College has been committed to two-way education. For us, this means educating our students, but also educating the wider community about our Aboriginal history and culture. To support this, the college has developed a professional learning institute and is currently developing an Aboriginal resource centre to house our artefacts, our stories, and our history. These activities are not a formal part of the college's education program, but rather an outreach education, which connect to our Dreaming Trail and History Walk. The Dreaming Trail was developed by Aboriginal elders as an educational tool to record and to celebrate aspects of traditional culture and lifestyle of Victorian Aboriginal tribes and clans. It introduces the general public to a special understanding of the natural world and Aboriginal cultural heritage through the promotion of Aboriginal culture, history, and environment. The Dreaming Trail provides the privileged opportunity to experience aspects of Aboriginal culture and spirituality as you step into sacred land.
What really motivated me into building a school was a tremendous need and tremendous potential of Aboriginal children. That's what motivated me. And the fact that he was all this wonderful energy.
It's called Worawa Aboriginal, where the eagle lives. It's just the perfect name. So magnificent, the scenery, you know, and just the place to have the type of dreams that we've got about a school for the children. It just fits in with us so completely, and our cultural way and the way we look at life. And of course, when they go to school in a place like this, I just feel they're going to grow and really fly.
Hyllus Maris, philosopher, writer, poet, artist, and founder of Worawa Aboriginal College, in her poem, Spiritual Song of the Aboriginal, writes beautifully about Aboriginal spirituality. And at Worawa, Hyllus's poem is recited every morning. It celebrates our Aboriginal heritage, reinforces pride in our Aboriginal identity, honours our moiety system and our spirit ancestors, our connection to country, our totemic beliefs, totemic relationships requires that people must learn how to take responsibility for relationships with the species and the totems, the sacred sites which are connected to totemic animals. I am a child of the Dreamtime people, part of this land like the Nile gum tree. I am the river softly singing, chanting our songs on the way to the sea. My spirit is the dust devils and the rajas that dance on the plains. I'm the snow, the wind and the falling rain. I'm part of the rocks and the red desert earth, as red as the blood that flows in my veins. I am eagle, crow and snake that glide through the rainforest that cling to the mountainside. I awakened here when the earth was new. There was emu, wombat, kangaroo, no other man of a different hue. I am this land, and this land is me. I am Australia.
gonna wash the dust off my soul. I'm gonna listen to some rock and roll. No cares, come what may, I'm making a beautiful day. Gonna drive my car to the sea. Swim out far, 'cause I believe that the waves will wash the gray away. I'm making a beautiful day. But let me hear you say, this place is all about, 'cause from above it all, you can't help but say, it's gonna be a beautiful day. It's gonna be a beautiful day. But let me hear you say, we'll sing, it's a beautiful day. And that's gonna be my beautiful day. Oh, oh, my, my, I'm learning to fly. Hey, hey, what's that you say? Let's not forget we're alive.
I would like to thank Dr. Peeler for delivering a beautifully crafted case study of the Worawa Aboriginal College, which works incredibly well with the mission of MGSE and what we're trying to achieve. The poetry, descriptive prose, singing, captivating landscapes, and the stunning photography combined to make this an incredibly moving experience for which we are grateful. Thank you.